Roll call.
Jenny Nelson.
Here.
Tom Coons.
Here.
Emily Leach. Here. Andrea Anderson. Karen Kavanaugh.
Here.
We hope that Andrea will join us. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce those who are here and even members of the board who have not yet entered, to our new interim superintendent, Dr. Cornelia Brown.
Hi, everybody.
Dr. Brown comes to us by way of Nashua most recently, where she stepped in as interim superintendent there after a sudden departure of the central office administration in Nashua. So the cliff note versions of how we hired her, I'm going to be very brief. We had a superintendent search, as I think all of you are aware of, a committee of about 15 people, and we did not find a suitable candidate. That was done back in the March, April, May timeframe. The SAU board decided in May to hire an interim and to make the recommendation committee much smaller, than 15 people. So Tom, who was chair of the SAU board at the time, myself and Don Austin, chair of Summersworth, essentially were the people who reviewed some resumes for the interim superintendent. Dr. Brown was the first person we brought to the SAU board, and we recommended her highly at that time. We voted the same evening that she met the SAU board to open negotiations with Dr. Brown and hope that she would join us. And she has. So what made Dr. Brown stand out to the SAU board? Just a couple of things. Her experience, her collaborative nature, which we've already had a chance to experience, many of us here, the breadth and depth of the recommendations. I was particularly impressed that her recommendations included both the president of the Nashua Teachers Union and the Nashua School Board Chair. So sort of two opposing sides, both recommended. Other search committee criteria included a demonstrable commitment to public education and a commitment to continuous self-improvement as evidenced by pursuing and obtaining a PhD. And of course, her actual interview with the SAU board, where her thoughtful, collaborative manner was evident, as well as her ability to grasp our particular needs as two distinct districts with quite different budgetary needs, among other things. So, Dr. Brown, would you like to say a few words?
I'm characteristically speechless after that introduction, although I did prepare, as I said to Judy, 2 hours of typed remarks and figured on a warm August evening that would go over really well. So I can start reading at any time if you'd like me to begin. No, it's my pleasure to be back. I was in SAU 56 back in 1988, believe it or not. I was the principal at Great Falls School. Very similar to this building in many, many ways. In 1990, that building was closed, and ironically, I was going to be a candidate here at the Rollinson Grade School as the principal. And before I was hired in the San Juan Regional School District. So my time here is very is very fond for me. Since then, I've been in a lot of different places. This is my 20th year as a superintendent of schools. I was in Nashua last year, different considerably than you folks, but when you drill down into it, I think you have some of the same themes. You're very interested in student achievement, very interested in how your kids are doing. I believe, like Nashua, you are good stewards of the public dollar, public trust, and take that responsibility very seriously. So I've been ably assisted by the folks in the SAU office, thanks to Katie and Marie. Had a nice tour with Kate three weeks ago. I call it the Cook's Tour. Marie and I have gone through the building, and I'm impressed with the amount of work that has taken place over the summer. So I got a chance to listen to not only what was going on in the facility, but also what's going on in the education program. I'm a real asset.
Big audience here, but Tracy?
Tracy Warren.
are you just looking at interim, like little pieces, or are you looking for something more? You know, are you, obviously we're looking for somebody permanent, so I was just wondering whether you're just fitting in and finding little pieces, or whether you're looking for a longer fit.
I think that both parties have an unprecedented opportunity to sort of test drive this relationship and see if it looks like it's a good fit. And so we'll see. We'll see if it looks like I'm a candidate the boards would be interested in long term, and if the communities are ones where I would like to stay.
Thank you.
Any other? All right, then we'll move along. We'll open things up to public comment. I was going to take a few minutes to just sort of remind everyone, but we have a lot of old hands here tonight, and no one really knew sort of about, because this is sort of the first meeting of the school year, I'm just going to remind everybody about the visitor orientation to the meeting and those things, but I'm going to skip that and just open it up to public comment, if there is public comment this evening. No comments by visitors. One of the things that I skipped on the agenda was the introduction of board members. Again, I think we're all here. And has everyone had a chance to meet Dr. Brown?
Yes.
Okay. So, thank you, Amber.
Hi. Sorry, I was delayed. It's for children, that's all.
All right, so now we'll move on to the consent calendar. There are two items on the consent calendar, the minutes from the Rollinsford Summer Sort of Policy Committee meeting, and that was Don Austin, myself, Matt Hamlin, and Jeremy Mosca going over the policies that were first reviewed this evening. And the other one is the minutes from the school board meeting. No pleasure of board. Consent calendar.
I make a motion to accept the calendar on this.
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Announcements. Are there any announcements? Look to the superintendent to see if there are any announcements. Discussion items. Principal update. Kate's going to give us a little update on the summer work at Rollinsford Grade School.
Sure. So I'll just start with facilities before I go into some of the other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The abatement that was happening in Annex Wall for the window replacement has been completed. The windows have been installed and are fantastic so far. They put the opening on the top half rather than the bottom half, which was the opposite before, so we lost all that wall space previously. In addition, we couldn't leave the windows open to get air ventilation, and now we can actually, even if it's raining, leave them open because of the way they slant, which is great for a brick building with children in it. So that's great, we're really happy about that. As you saw when you came in, the pavement on the playground has been completed. They also evened off the ground. There was a place where we had a nice pond in the corner where it sort of had settled in and we no longer could play basketball, and it was also just during winter that was evened out, so that's nice. So we have basketball courts and no court. Three-phase power, which the first half was last year.
The second third was last year.
Outside was done 2 years ago. The main building was done last summer. The gym and the annex is to be completed. The expectation is next Friday. There's just a couple things they're waiting on, just parts of breaker parts. So we're excited about that to be done. The storage shed has been installed and completed. The floor was bored this morning, so it is now in there as well, which also then meant the storage unit was falling down up here is gone. The one on the hill will be gone some weekend in September, but it's not a priority right now. We need to finish some other things before the building opens. We had exterior lights installed on the outside of the annex. We didn't have exterior lights on the annex building, and so now we have lights where we park on the north side, which is nice for the adults that park here in the morning or late at night. and as well on the back side of the playground for when families come at night, so there's some exterior lighting for them, which is really nice. The staff bathroom, so the guidance office used to have a little bathroom, but you could only access it from inside the guidance office, which then meant it wasn't usually available because there's often things going on in the guidance office. So now there's a door from the hallway that has a staff member key lock that could now make that bathroom possible for the staff. We only had one staff bathroom, now we have two, which is nice for the adults. The final programming was taken out of the hallways. Title I is no longer in the hallways. It's in the old guidance space, so it was the last program that we offered that was not taking place in a classroom or a space. So now everything is out of the hallways, which we're really excited about. So the Title I space is now unfinished. It was the old guidance office, which then means the guidance office and our de-escalation zen den has been created downstairs where the old library used to be, where Mrs. Wright and Mr. Conte used to be. A wall was put up with doors to create an office for guidance, so if it needed to be a confidential meeting or a phone call. And then the Zen Den de-escalation space is being worked on right now, which we've been trying to accomplish since, I think, 7 years ago. So we're really excited about having a place for students to go and work on their self-regulation and some of their impulse control without feeling like they've been in trouble or that they have done something wrong, but really to work on those skills and strategies so that they can be integrated into the classroom without consequences or missing learning time. So we're excited about that. The classroom rooms have been painted from kindergarten all the way up to here, including the hallways. They hadn't been painted in over 10 years, and they needed some attention, so they've all been painted, which was very exciting. The bathroom renovations in the main building, the boys and the girls, all the plumbing has been done, the fixtures, we still have to wait for the two sinks to be done. And once those are in, then we'll finish the partitions, but we're waiting for that stuff to be installed so we're not getting anything in the process and doing anything. So that's very good. Mike Woolley has been working tirelessly since about April on the project, so it's exciting. The final ADA lift has been installed. It is completed. We're just waiting on the state inspection. So the very first inspections have to be done by the state. After that, it's done by the company. So we're waiting for the state to come and inspect it, which is supposed to be the last week of August. The stainless steel cabinets, shelving, everything in the kitchen has been done. It's replaced. It's all on wheels, which makes it possible for us to actually take it out and clean it. And it also meets all code for sanitation in the kitchen. The location of all the classrooms has been done. We have five different teachers that were moving to different spaces. And then tons of technology upgrades and replacements. The three smart boards have been ordered. They have arrived. They just won't be installed for a couple of weeks. The Wi-Fi upgrade, which was also a grant, has been approved and completed, which we needed desperately in the building, as you all know. Our Chromebooks are in, so now every third grader through sixth grader will have a Chromebook. Our iPads are in to replace the broken ones and to continue the K through 2 iPad program. So that's facilities.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, there's a lot to tell you how I cannot, any of us that are in the building can tell you the work that Dick and Rick and Janie have been putting in. Every summer I know I talk about it because it just blows my mind every summer, but this summer in particular, in addition to all the other contractors and women that have been working, and just the Dick's ability to negotiate all of that and make that run smoothly and chip in with electric if they need them on any given day or to help make construction, it's just been, they've worked really tirelessly and with such a great attitude, and the atmosphere has been just awesome. It's been a really nice place even though it's been really busy and a little disheveled.
No, and it really is remarkable. I've had a chance to walk around a couple times this summer inside, and you see an empty classroom, the floor's just been done, and it's been brightly painted in that new sort of yellow shade, and it's like, it just looks so bright and beautiful and welcome. It just looks so great. You guys have probably had a chance too, but it's
a little bit, but I'm amazed hearing all the whole list.
I can't say enough about just, and they're like, Jenny texts me if I'm not here, like, hey, this is what we did today, what do you think? She'll send pictures, and it's been a really nice job.
Yeah, when you think that really three people are
doing
it all, it's pretty amazing. Yeah. All right, then you're going to carry on.
Just to say that ESY extended school year wraps up this week. It's the fifth week it ends. Wally Camp was originally going to have to be out of the space this week. They no longer are going to have the other space. They could finish in here, which was really nice. I spoke with Andy and today, and they're just relieved about that, so that's good for them and for us to have the kids still here and sort of the transition of less gaps, so that's nice for some of our kids. Just wanted to touch base on some of the professional learning that the staff has done. 9 staff members went to the Oakville School Symposium in Oregon in June. Learned so much, and it was really nice to be around like-minded people that have the same vision for education and hear how they utilize their community and their resources to bring about the change that's taking place in our schools. It's pretty incredible. It was really worthwhile, and I hope that every staff member has an opportunity over the next couple of years to attend, because it is inspiring in so many ways.
It's nice that there were that many 9, and that was done through a grant.
All grant, yeah, the grant. Allocation grant, yeah. All of it.
Yeah, work on the grants and getting the folks out, that's great.
Yeah, it was such a good for all of us, really was. Additionally, we had 6 people that took a week-long course up in Maine and Portland for our new math program. On top of those 6, 9 others did the same workshop online and are completing it right now because it was far more difficult online than the course that people went to in Portland.
I'm in Portland.
Several others doing other online courses. A couple people are teaching courses at the university. And then 19 of us have been in different book studies throughout the course of the summer as well. So there's a lot of professional learning that's gone on while the building is being renovated. Our brain, our spirits about education are getting a little attention as well. And then I did just want to compliment Caroline Chartier, our administrative assistant. And she has been such a trooper and so efficient and kind and welcoming to everybody. And I don't think any one of us have had to ask for anything because she does it before we even ask, and it's so professional. And
if she doesn't know that something has to be done and someone asks her, like report card covers, she was like, oh, and then we've done that afternoon.
Yeah.
But she had no idea that she had to do
them. She's just an incredible energy to have in this space and just to work with, and I feel really grateful for that. And then last, the staff, through a grant, is going to spend our first day on August 28th at the Brown Center for Innovative Learning at UNH. Doing just team building and communication and collaborative problem solving as a way to bring us together and get our brains around what we want our classrooms to feel like for the next 10 months.
Yeah, comments, questions from the board, Kate?
Exciting stuff.
It does help, and I ran into Mrs. Wright, the kindergarten teacher, last week, and she said something about, oh, I'll be at the garden club meeting if I'm not doing a home visit, because the kindergarten teacher does a home visit for every kindergarten student. I mean, these are things that people in the community don't really know about, but it's good to, I mean, they're busy all the time. Yes, Kate.
Two more things. I sent you the letter that went home to families today, and you know, I have copies if you didn't get it. And then second, just interesting about Becky. So I was at a cookout with Inexor, with people that I don't know this world or this side of my world, and just talking, and this girl says to me, oh, you work in office. Yes, she said, I heard the neatest thing today. And I said, what? She goes, I heard you have the best kindergarten teacher in the state. And I said, as a matter of fact, I do. She goes, what's her name? I said, her name is, actually, my husband said, her name is Becky Wright. She said, I have a friend that's a new parent, and could not stop raving about her experience with a home visit. And I thought, it's such a small world and such a nice thing that I randomly stumbled across someone and was able to share that. So I thought that was pretty cool.
Very nice. Very nice. Thank you. As usual, Bailey and Noah are going to be our, because they said so in June that they would be returning. They're both going to be seniors at Summersworth and Marshwood. Respectively, but they never join us for August, because after all, they have no school events to report on at this point. So we'll just pass over those. All right, so the next discussion item is the sort of the first reading. I don't know how many of you have had a chance to look through. Yes, Tom, I left your open. Look at you, you're just exploring. So,
we used to have them?
Then we started changing so quickly that we
wasn't working.
All right, so, so once Tom gets finished exploring his name tag, we'll talk about the policies that are in our packet. I don't know if people have had a chance to read through them, and if so, we can go through and just, this is our review of them. We are not taking any action on them, so we may have questions. The list was much longer that we reviewed in our meeting back in June, but anything that was required by law, priority required by law, we decided there was no point in bringing it because it was required by law, and therefore we were obviously going to adopt it. So we didn't bring most of those forward to the board. There is one that is here only for us. It did not go to the Summersworth tour, and that's the one about the rules of order. Summersworth does follow Robert's rules of order very strictly. We do not, usually. So that's one that if we want to discuss this evening, we can. That we, you know, we follow more the New Hampshire School Board Association's guidelines. It's more what we have been doing, but again, it's open to discussion whether or not we want to do that or back up to a...
I'm happy with this. I'm happy with whatever group wants.
And are there other have you had a chance to look and you have any questions? Do you want to name them each individually, or do you want to say if you have any questions on any of them? How would you like to have the discussion?
I don't have any questions on any of them, so it'd
be straightforward.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And is so that the really the only one so just the rules of order or all the ones you included in the actually could.
Yeah. All ones are included and be discussed this evening, and even brief, they can even be briefly discussed next month when we will take action on them.
They, with any of the changes, are the highlighted?
The only changes are the highlighted, correct, like the yellow highlights. Correct. So we have the fuel renewal contract in front of us, and
so it's a new name for the Wisconsin Energy now. Mm-hmm. So will we do business already with Boardwalk? Who was it that we were?
Same company. It's through the same company.
So every year, either the school district, either Marie takes the lead for us, or the town takes the lead. This year, the town took the lead. Last year, Marie took the lead, and this year, the town took the lead. So
do we know what we paid last year?
Sorry,
wait.
What? Do you know what we paid last year?
Same price.
So, so the action item would be to accept the. We do need to accept the agreement, right? We do need to accept the agreement.
Yes.
Well, I make a motion that we accept the agreement now with the council members who formerly reported on the fuels at 18 cents for the cost per gallon.
Any further discussion? I passed over budget because in August we don't, as any of you who saw my emails, I think the whole board and Marie and Dr. Brown saw them, we don't usually do a budget update because we haven't, we're busy closing the books and getting things ready for that. So in September, we'll have pretty much the end of the of fiscal year 17 and the beginning of fiscal year 18.
There is something on the budget. There is something.
But there is something on the budget to discuss. Is that what you said?
The schedule.
The schedule, yes, yes, yes. So while we're not doing the actual budget, we are looking at the schedule.
The watermark is still up there. It said draft on it. This is draft, and so you guys can roll with it.
Okay.
It is a draft.
So this is good, and I can report that the budget committee did vote to move the budget committee meeting on the school budget to December 13th. So it had been scheduled for the 20th. It is now the 13th, which is what is on this, which is on this schedule. So.
So what I provided for you with the budget schedule is the actual requirements, the law requirements of that and the Department of Revenue, when certain things will need to be done by. And that's, we look at those dates and backdate it to make sure that we comply with the requirement. And we basically just use the same dates that we've done in the past 5 years, and we just change the date that they fell on in the coming year.
So we won't be seeing anything really, sort of a draft until October. We'll be looking at around then.
You would get a copy obviously before the meeting.
Yeah.
At some point, if you September meeting or. September meeting, you give direction to the superintendent, or some idea, and then we'll incorporate some of that, what your recommendations are, or what your suggestions are, into the proposed budget.
Yeah, that's a pretty, it's what we've done for the last number of years, and probably many years before that. We'll have our 5:30 meeting before our board meeting in October, where we'll do budget discussions, and the same thing. Essentially in November and in December as well. So. And if need be, we will schedule extra meetings. I think there was at least 1 year when we actually scheduled some extra meetings so we can have more time.
Well, this is good because, those calendars fill up fast. So
yeah.
Once we start getting into this.
So yes, let's all remember to get these on our calendars with the 5:30 time. We don't have to take any action.
Just a consensus at the system.
Everybody's happy to have a calendar.
Thanks, Marie.
Thank you.
We'll catch you tomorrow. What do you have? See if there's any major. All right, we'll give everybody a chance to do that. Is there any other budget information to go over to tonight? Any other budget?
Nope. Thank you for asking at this time.
We'll just give everybody a moment to finish getting into the
chat. I know I will.
Oh, no. Well, Emily is making first doing it. All right. So for old business, we have community connections. We have two things to talk about there. We were going to talk about the first day for teachers, but it looks like the first day that the teachers are going to all be together. You only have 1 day before school starts, right? We have two.
The 29th? Mm-hmm. I said they've got plans.
So the 28th, you're going to be at the Brown Center.
Correct.
And the 29th, you're going to be here in the school without kids.
Correct.
So did we want to do something for them here at the school on the 29th?
Mm-hmm.
Are there people on the committee who are have something who can take charge of that?
Sure.
Yes. All right. Well, that
What are you doing on your other day?
They're going to the Brown Center.
Yeah, I know.
On Tuesday, Cindy Rhodes is coming, who's our application consultant, so she'll be here on Tuesday. So we'll be in the building working on that.
So it's the 27th you'll be?
Nope. 28th is Brown Center, 29th.
So the 29th here.
It's the 29th here, Tuesday. With the math person.
Yes.
August, yes, in a couple weeks.
Okay, let me chat.
All right. I can help Penny help anyway.
Well, not help, ideas. But we'll brainstorm.
Ideas and numbers of adults will be in the building. That's really
smaller and smaller. Like, whoa.
Yeah,
34.
What we need to know.
34.
34 adults will be in the building? Our short notes, and that includes your guest.
That's it.
All right. Thank you, you all, of course, will let me know if there's anything here. Thank you. Our committee's great. And the other thing for that, for the community connections is we should probably plan to get out our second newsletter.
That's the best one.
Did you all get the logo proposal?
I did.
Yeah.
Yeah. I couldn't open it on my phone, but I could open it on my computer.
I could.
Could you?
Absolutely.
Okay, so yes, it was like, it looked like a desk, and then the line goes across.
Yeah, I leave it up to, because it's black and white, it's not like we can go crazy.
It's true.
I should get up on that scaffold and take a picture of this.
Please don't.
Yeah.
That's not a good idea.
I'm just
kidding. But that's a good idea.
So what do we want to think on the timing of it?
Go ahead. Well, I was just going to add to it. I don't know if Emily, he doesn't have an Anna.
We'll get Tom's attention in a minute.
I received a pretty informative letter from the middle school. Did you as well?
And I haven't read it yet.
I've skimmed through it, you know, because I wasn't going to be able to take in, all the dates and everything, but it was pretty thorough explaining, you know, about their extracurricular activities, when things start, after school help, the late bus. It was very informative. I hope that parents are able to, you know, read that information.
Is that something that they did last year as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
I just assume that it'd be
pretty. It might be good for us in our newsletter to reiterate a few of those points.
Yeah.
You know,
so what our late bus, like, look at that.
Yeah, that's so. What do we want in it? So that would be helpful to have in there.
Yeah, that's true.
What else? I forgot to bring my copy of the item to serve.
Well, I don't know if there's any other highlights from, you know, Kate's.
Yeah, maybe could you send us the list that you kind of just
raised now? I mean, I'm just even saying from her letter.
Oh yeah,
upcoming dates and things.
Yeah.
If you need more than that, I mean, the other things, that's just the big things that jump out at my parents and families.
Learn for each.
I mean, since we're making the effort to.
And so would the goal be then to get it out before the first day of school?
Yeah.
Once we have an agenda, I can write that very quickly. And again, we talked about keeping it relatively simple.
Yep.
And approaching, you know, making sure we're covering our three.
Yeah, so do we have anything relating to our goals that we can include?
In summer, so we can.
Right. Well,
well, the communication costs. So our number one goal was placing teachers on the appropriate salary step based on their qualifications and experience. And obviously, we're going to be going into negotiations. So, you know, we will be entering into negotiations, and we won't be writing about those until they're completed.
Right.
We won't be writing about the negotiating. We'll be.
Do we want to say anything about your budget committee, like trying to get some guidance?
Yeah. Well, actually, that's a good segue. I have some. I'll give you a more quick update on the budget committee meeting, but.
We're working with the budget committee towards that, I think.
Sure.
And might also just be helpful include the next budget committee meeting, because people are often dependent.
Mm-hmm.
They at least they have the option. They may not know otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting after another audience. Hey, I want to go to this.
Mm-hmm.
Budget
and school board meeting.
Right.
We try to.
But yes, and that's to me seems like enough to try to get in there.
Sure.
Do something out of school because we're going to keep it to one page, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. This is communicate consistently and clearly, so we're doing it again. And investigate ways to work more closely with town boards and committees. So again, we're working with the talking to the budget committee. So it looks like we're hitting them. So
yeah.
We're coming up with those points. That'd be great. And then I think then what we did in the past was we'll go out before we meet again. We'll have a draft, quickly go around. Okay. And we should think about a nice small token for the SAU staff that puts this together as well. So, maybe not a small token, but a token of some sort to show our appreciation for what they put into doing that. Excellent. So those were the two things under the community connections. Marshall contract items, we're keeping a list, and I know that Dr. Brown has the list that I think of the folder that Jenny had.
Yes.
So anything else comes up?
Okay.
Five
situation? So what? 0.5?
Yes, sorry, yes.
So I was wondering, I know that we had with Summersworth the situation where one parent lived in Rollinsford and another parent lived in Summersworth and they had joint custody. We paid half tuition to Summersworth. And I'm wondering if we have a similar caveat in our contract with Marshwood if one parent lives in Southbrook or Elliott, and one parent lives in Rollinsford, and they have joint custody. Do we pay half tuition? Or
I don't think so. We defer to.
We don't know.
If there's any
at this point, we don't know what that situation is. It is. We're not aware of it.
I don't think there's any contract language that speaks to that.
But it might be something we might want to consider putting in. So if we could add to that list.
Based on residency.
Well, if it's 50-50 custody, and they're half time in each place,
and it's
right.
Not a daily decree
for
the school.
I don't know that, but I
just asked because I remember we had like 23.5 students that we had tuitioned into Summersworth, and I was like,
we know that Marshwood already has that scenario within their own. That they already have something like that going on, where a family is. I mean, we're talking about
between Elliot and
yeah, it could be another.
They have their own.
They may have a similar situation. How do they handle it?
So it sounds like you're saying maybe it's worth a discussion between the superintendents first, just to say that we have the boards have that we have this question because we knew.
Have they gone through this? Have they gone through this scenario where they have a child who was being split 50-50, you know, they have custody issue 50-50, and there's the expectation that they would be in school 50% of the time there. How do they handle that?
I have a meeting with Dr. Nash on the 22nd, and I will raise this with her.
All right, and I guess being in the same way when it was Summersworth. I mean, Summersworth was our school of record, but we only paid half the tuition to them because half the time they lived in Summersworth and half the time they lived.
Right, they went to school full time.
So again, yeah, school of record will be Marshwood High School. There is no, if the families live in both places, but do we pay full tuition if they're actually living half the time in the Marshwood district?
Is that?
Yes, that's right.
No.
That's right.
But great, thank you, and then we'll take it from there.
What she says.
Yeah, thank you.
Any other?
And let's see, Andrea is our rep to the late start, the Marshwood late start discussions that are going on. And I'm assuming you did not meet over the summer.
No.
So.
No news there.
All right, and then on August 2nd, we had the second quarter review in the budget committee. So it was an interesting meeting on the 2nd. It opened with some of the members noting that Alan Robinson, who is the chair, those members were saying that they no longer lived in town. So therefore could not serve on the committee. And they actually wanted to vacate his position that night, and Alan was not there that night because of work. So a number of us were caught off guard with that and just sort of said, well, slow down a little bit. Let's find out what's really going on and not vacate his position immediately. So the vice chair, Michelle Small, is to get in contact with Alan. And I believe she has sent email that she has been in contact with him. He'll be in touch with the budget committee. So if Alan is no longer eligible to serve, his position will be filled by that committee. Historically, the budget committee fills their, this is how they've done it in the past few years, they've filled their vacant position with the next highest vote getter. Now, it's not how we do it on the school board, but it's how they've been doing it, so we'll have to see how that goes. During the school budget discussion, I asked the committee for their suggestions on how to address the step deficits. I'm not calling it the step deficit because I don't know what to call it. That we are now in with now six teachers, not five teachers, but now 6 years with the start of this year. And their thoughts on, and also their thoughts on multi-year contracts. There were a number of different opinions among the committee on the multi-year contracts. It kind of came down to maybe they would, you know, support a two-year contract. There were all sorts of information going around there. On the step deficit, again, the suggestions were kind of mixed with a focus on give back on insurance. They really wanted give back on insurance as a top priority. And when I pointed out that the union had indeed given back as much as they possibly could during the last collective bargaining agreement, there was very little comment on that from the committee, just to say that that's what they really want is healthy. So some other comments were the need to make sure that we have top-notch qualified teachers and are reviewing them and observing them and everything else to ensure that they meet our standards. I thought that was kind of interesting. That sort of came out of the blue, but you know, just making sure that we really have the best staff here that we could possibly have. A note that 5% each for step and track was too high. You know, that was just a comment that was thrown out. Some people seem to remember a three-year contract a few years ago, maybe around the 2007 age as the recession was setting in, that there was a three-year contract that gave teachers 5% raise for each year. I can't find any evidence of that. I can find a two-year contract that was a 3 and 3.5, but I can't find any evidence of 5%, but I'll double check as we go back through contracts. And should we decide to offer a multi-year contract, a suggestion was made by a couple of people to maybe have a benchmark in the contract against cost of living increases, I think, so that should the cost of living go way down, or if we go into a recession again, or go way up, that we reopen it, just simply reopen the contract. We had some contracts language like that in the past on if Cadillac tax kicked in, we would reopen a contract. So anyway, that's just an idea of a benchmark, something like that. So that's my review on that. And the video is out and available to see. Anyone, if you have any questions on that. All right, any other old business? All right, future meeting dates, the next MSAT 36, 35, we'll just make, combine our two numbers. Anyway, the next Marshwood meeting is the 23rd of August. Our next school board meeting is September 14th. On September 18th, we have an SAU board meeting. Kate included the open house, is that the 7th? So the open house is the 7th of September?
Mm-hmm. They go from 5 to 6, which we've been doing for a couple years now. And then open house is from 6 to 7. Sign-ups for student-led conferences will be out that night, so parents can sign up for those, because those are in November. But that's the first big event of the year.
Yep, it's easy. Come wander around, the kids always just still look so fresh, and parents still look so fresh. Any other specific dates?
It's the 18th.
Yeah.
The 18th and 19th. That's the
it's a Monday?
Monday, it's September 18th.
That's the 18th. Any other dates that people want to put on the calendar? Well, this has gone very quickly. All right. Closing comments by visitors. No closing comments by visitors. Closing comments by board members. We'll just go around the table and see if anyone had a Tom. You should see.
Motion.